SharePoint list is a collection of information, like tables in Excel or in a database. Lists consist of rows of columns that contain data. SharePoint Online includes a number of standard lists that are frequently used in sites. For example, there's a list for announcements, a list app for calendar and for contacts. And calendar and contacts are special because they can be synchronized with Microsoft Outlook. So you can have a calendar that's in SharePoint that every single member of your team can also display in their own Outlook. Links lists are designed to make it easy for users to jump directly to a resource online. Issue tracking lists are used to submit, prioritize, assign, and track work on issues, and they're used in a variety of settings, from IT help desks to tracking hotel guest room maintenance. The tasks list is a to-do list for a team. And all of these are apps that are available in SharePoint, and most of them have been for a very long time. You'll also see lists that come from a totally different source, because Microsoft has made a big investment in lists, and there are new lists that are available, not just here in SharePoint, but in Microsoft Teams and in Microsoft List itself. At this point, we have 8 templates that are available for Microsoft List, so you may be working with an asset manager list, content scheduler, employee onboarding, event itinerary, issue tracker, recruitment tracker, travel requests, which I'll show you an example of in a moment, and work progress tracker. The Microsoft 365 lists are really built on SharePoint lists. And as a matter of fact, if you're using a Microsoft 365 list in Microsoft Teams or elsewhere, the data is going to be stored in SharePoint. But most of them give you even more of a head start than the traditional list apps do. And if none of these lists from Microsoft 365 lists or from the SharePoint list apps were exactly what was needed to meet your organization's business requirements, then someone in your organization can create a custom list, either from scratch or from Excel or from an existing list. I'd like to show you a couple of lists so you can see what they look like. This is the travel requests list in residential sales. And just a few things about it let me know that this is probably a Microsoft list. The way the requester is presented, the circle around the airline, whether it's approved or not being formatted. Let me show you a more traditional list. This is a custom list that was created because the asset inventory wasn't exactly what we wanted. And this list was created originally in Microsoft Excel, and that Excel table was used to create this custom list in SharePoint Online. You don't need to know how a list was created in SharePoint in order to use it. Regardless of the type of list you're using or its genesis, the processes and tools used to work with items and lists are the same. There are a couple of ways we'll enter a new item in a list. The first is simply to click the New button, and a form will open, and this is a form that's designed particularly for this list. And so I'm prompted for a trip title, and I'm going to enter Detroit, December 17th, 2020. And the reason is going to be to view a solar install near client site. Requester, you can enter your own information, but many times we might be putting in a travel request for someone else, so we could enter someone else's name as well. But I'm going to enter my own information. Notice I can add multiple people. The location is Detroit, Michigan. And the travel start date, if I need to be there on the 17th, it's going to be 12/16/2020. But notice that I could also use the date picker, and I'm going to do that for my travel end, which is actually going to end on the 18th. Airline Delta. I actually have a pick list that I can use here. Estimated airfare, $450. Hotel. And this is pretty cool. So I'm going to enter the name of my hotel. And the Crowne Plaza, Detroit, downtown. So this list is actually looking specifically for hotels. My estimated hotel cost is going to be $280. And then I'm submitting this request, so I'm not going to approve it now. And I could add attachments here. Simply click and add whatever attachments I needed to add to support this request. When I'm all done, I click Save. Another way I could add a new item is to edit in grid view. And when I switch a list to grid view, I get something that looks a lot like Excel. I have columns and rows. So when I add a new item here, I just type in the cell. Type in the cell. And if I went to, for example, the travel start date and clicked, I'll still get all of the tools that I had supporting this data entry. So I don't have to use the form in order to get date pickers or to be able to resolve requesters. All I need to do is enter information. So if I begin entering Ray here, I can pick him up here, tab from cell to cell, just as you would in Microsoft Excel. And when I'm all done, I simply either drop down to the next row to save. Notice I have a progress meter on the left-hand side. And when this record has been appropriately saved, then I can enter yet another record. So use the form if you wish, or work in grid view. When you're done in grid view and you exit, you go back to the original view. It looks like this. Now, I can also edit my information. So this wasn't a great name here. I select the row I want to edit and click edit. And I can open the form again and make modifications. Or I can simply drop back into grid view and enter the information I want to enter. If I'm in grid view, I can also simply choose to delete this record. And that record now that says type in the cell was my travel request name is now winging its way to the recycle bin for the residential sales site.